I had JB Smoove on my show a couple of times.
Yeah.
And JB was a writer for a while for Saturday Night Live.
Yeah.
And he told me he was a killer at going in on those writing meetings. Mm-hmm. He was so good at the table read that this is his estimation. I don't know what you felt, but he says most of my stuff, this is his quote, did not make it on the air. How could a guy be so good at the table read and have so many great ideas and then not get his stuff on the air?
Where JB was a stone cold killer, an assassin to a degree I had never seen before or since, was in the pitch on Monday.
Everyone would sit down and kind of pitch their ideas. I would stand up as if I was performing my pitches.
It was like a stand-up doing a character of a guy pitching sketch ideas. You know, he had the thing about like Spider-Man goes to the dry cleaner and gets Batman's costume. And so, and that is a far better pitch than an actual sketch. Like you write the sketch, there's not much, I remember it just had a thing about a guy with a really long cigarette, like the ash would go. And then he would act it out, you know, and laugh. The other one of my favorite of JB's is the helicopter family. Everybody in a family was a helicopter pilot. So they would come home and they would walk real low and scream real loud.
Now, you see, when he tells me those stories, I go, JB, you're a genius. And he'd go, I know I am. And I go, I don't understand how they didn't make the sketch, the helicopter family. I don't even understand. He goes, that's right.
I remember the first time I met Larry David, the first thing I said to him is like, I'm so happy that you figured out how to get the essence of JB on television, because I think a lot of people have known him over the years and had the question we're having, which is how can this guy have these incredible ideas and we can't figure out how to take it from like there to sketch? Whereas, you know, there are actual scenes in Curb Your Enthusiasm where basically JB will pitch like three crazy ideas and it's gold.
Pussy tea, mm-hmm. huh? All the taste of pussy without the commitment. I put that shit in a tea bag.
He has, you know, for the fact that he had a very short time on SNL, the fact that he left as a legend, he was the greatest pitcher that was ever there. And it's very hard to be the greatest at anything.